Ballin' boy.
Shoutout coming at you again for episode number 8 of the HurriBlog. Thank y'all for watching. Thank you all the subscribers. I got like over 75 subscribers now, so my goal is to reach 100. But hey, keep watching. First off, good news. My season tickets came in this week. So, yeah. Section 100, row 8, seat 14 and 13. See? 14 and 13. And my parking passes for the games, and my two tickets to the Florida State Miami game. So basically, I'm already ready. I just need to get my rental car. About 10 more days till the season starts, so very excited about that. First off, I have some ventilation I want to do, and I know y'all heard about it. Cook and Smith transferring out of Miami. Nobody knew the real reason, but I found out the real reason is because they wasn't getting that much playing time, so packed up a little bag and left. I heard one of them went to Rice. I don't know where the other one is going. Okay. I really don't understand. You would leave Miami for Rice just because you wasn't getting that much playing time? I mean, this is the thing that irks me about these college football players, these premium down to college football players. They want to be the star. Y'all not playing for a contract. Y'all playing for your school, a championship, and pride. Those three things. And it's like nobody on anybody's team is a star. It's a whole team effort. You want to abandon your team 10 days before the regular season, 10 days before a big game rivalry game away in Tallahassee, and you want to abandon your team? You have no heart. That's all I gotta say. I don't know if that's the real reason because they're not getting that playing time, but that's what I heard. If that's the reason, and we don't need it down here in Miami, like seriously, y'all, Cook, Smith, Bryce Brown.
See if you can read this. You're fired. And in case your ears are fucked, get the fuck out!
None of that. We don't need none of that here. Alright, we need players. We don't need no prima donna sissy type shit. And besides, we already have two quarterbacks, AJ Highsmith and Ja'Cory. I heard AJ is doing, kind of good. He's a rookie out of Missouri, but, he's learning the ropes. And you already know about Ja'Cory, so there's enough said there. But, hey, we'll do it without you. We'll build something without y'all. We don't need that type of distraction on the team. And look at me talking like I'm on the team, but still. We don't need all that. So, okay, my next point. The people we need to watch out for on Florida State. everybody know about Christian Ponder and about his arm and his mobility around the pocket.
To either side, here's the snap. Option play by Ponder, makes his cut to the 35 to the 40. He's to the 45 to the 50. Ponder to the 45 to the 40. Ponder to the 35 to the 30. Ponder yes. Dropped it down to the 26-yard line. Christian Ponder runs.
He tore our secondary up last year at Dolphin Stadium. That's the main person we need to watch for is him. And from what I've seen from Seminoles.com, their running game is not that much to be afraid of or anything. They don't have Deuce. Don't have the guy Deuce no more. They have some dude. I forgot his name. Jermaine Thomas. That's his name. Jermaine Thomas, and basically one practice, 24 yards and 6 carries. So it's really all our defense got to do is just clog the middle, or basically have Sean Spence cover the outside, and then they'll be good. And all I got to say about Florida State is basically they're on the same level or the same path that we were on last year. They have a lot of freshmen there. A lot of people are arrested. I'm not going to go there, but, you already know about that. A lot of freshmen there making freshman's mistake. But, Florida State is nothing to be taken lightly, or anything. They're still on rival, and they still got some good people on there. But it's basically all we have to do is just look out for Ponders and just keep an eye on that running game. The defense is something we need to worry about, because the Russian defense is almost the top of the line. But tend to give up a lot of long passes, a lot of TD passes. So secondary, no. Defensive line, yes, we need to watch out for those. It brings me to my next point. Last week I told y'all I was gonna give you the guy's name on eBay who basically sent me my decals for my helmet. The authentic one. If y'all haven't seen it, I'll show it to y'all right now. This one right here. And I put his name at the bottom. I don't know how to pronounce his name, but that's his eBay name. So if you want, he'll make you a custom helmet, because like I said, he's an official dealer for the NFL and the NCAA. And I've been talking to him the past couple of weeks, and he told me he makes helmets. He has overstocked with NFL helmets and NCAA helmets. So just talk to him, he'll give you a good price. You won't be spending more than $200. That's about it for a good authentic helmet like that. It's not a bad price. All right, last thing I want to say is I want to know your opinion about the upcoming game for the state. What's going to happen? I already said my piece. What's going to happen to the team and everything? And give me your opinion about this whole Smith and Cook transferring thing. I know some of y'all mad, and maybe some of y'all glad. I don't know. Just give me some. Insight about that. And I also want to know who is going to Tallahassee next week. I want to know so I can meet up with y'all. Just drop me a line or email me, or just send me a message on here. But anyways, I'll be back next week Friday. That's going to be my packing day, because I'm going to be staying up in Tallahassee for a little bit. But just get jumping line. I'll see y'all next week. And hope to see y'all in Tallahassee. Later.
Come to do the rest. Step in the way, multiple shots are going through the test. You must have gone back and drunk, bought you the best. And now we're back.